Now, another very common method for binomial series is algebraic method. And in algebraic method, we try and express the series in terms of summation. And then we'll try and work out general term in such a way that we can somehow simplify the summation. I'll take up an example. Say, for example, suppose the question is, I need to work out 1 into NC1 plus 2 into NC2, 3 into NC3, and it goes up to N into NCN. So I can express this series as summation R varies from 1 to N R into NCR. Now, what I need to do is somehow I need to change this R and I need to express everything in terms of some other function of N minus 1 or N plus 1 or R minus 1 or R plus 1. So I have to express it in terms of some other NCR. Now, in this method, what I need to do is I need to change this term. I need to change it in terms of some binomial coefficient for which summation will be simple. So what I'll do is I'll expand it. I'll write it as R from 1 to N R, and this is factorial N, factorial R, and factorial N minus R. Now I have a problem with this R. I do not want this R here, right? So what I can do is I can cancel this R with R into factorial R minus 1. So R and R will cancel. So I can simply write it as summation R varies from 1 to N, and this is simply R, factorial N. I'll write it as R into factorial R minus 1, and then N minus R. Now here this R and R will cancel. Now again, I want to express it in terms of NCR. Now what I see here is R minus 1, and here it is N minus R. So I can express it as N minus 1 minus R minus 1. In that case, 1 and 1 will cancel. So what I'll do is I'll also express this N as summation R varies from 1 to N. I'll write N into factorial N minus 1, factorial R minus 1, and then N minus R. So now I can take this N out because summation is in terms of R, not in terms of N. So I'll take this N out, and then I can write this summation as value of R varies from 1 to N, and this is nothing but N minus 1 C R minus 1. Now if I'll put the value of R, then this series is actually nothing but N minus 1 C 0, N minus 1 C 1, and plus N minus 1 C N minus 1, which is nothing but sum of all binomial coefficient of the series having N plus 1 index, right? So the sum of the series is simply 2 to the power N minus 1. So answer to this question will be N into 2 to the power N minus 1. Let us take up another question, and the question is 1 into 2 NC2, 2 into 3 into NC3, and then N minus 1 N into NCN. And I'll try and solve this question using algebraic method. So I can express it as summation. Now value of R, it varies from 2 and it goes up to N. So R varies from 2 to N. And then I'll simply write this as NCR. Now if it is 2, then it is 2 here. For 3, it'll be 3. For N, it'll be N. So here it'll be R and R minus 1. So I need to simplify this series, right? So I need to get rid of R minus 1 and R. So what I'll do is I can write it as summation R varies from 2 to N, R minus 1 R. I can write it as factorial N, factorial R, factorial N minus R. So from 2 to N, R minus 1 and R. Now in order to cancel this R minus 1 and R, I have to express this R as R into R minus 1, and then R minus 2 factorial, and then it'll be N minus R. Now, since here we have R minus 2, in the numerator, I'll need N minus 2. So I'll also write N, N minus 1, and then factorial N minus 2. Now here R minus 1 and R will get cancelled. Now N, N minus 1, it is independent of R. I can take it out of the summation, right? So I can write it as N, N minus 1, summation R varies from 2 to N, and here I'll get N minus 2 factorial upon R minus 2 factorial, and then N minus R. So which is nothing but this is N, N minus 1 summation R varies from 2 to N, N minus 2 C R minus 2. So which is N, N minus 1, and then N minus 2 C 0, N minus 2 C 1, and then N minus 2 C N minus 2, which is nothing but 2 to the power N minus 2. So answer to this question will be N, N minus 1, 2 to the power N minus 2. So let us take up another question, which is 1 square C1, 2 square C2 and n square Cn. So again, I can express it as summation. The value of R varies from 1 to n and there'll be R square into NCR. So again, I'll expand NCR. So I'll write R varies from 1 to n, R square, factorial n, factorial R, and there'll be factorial n minus R. So I'll cancel one of the R with factorial R. So I'll write R equals 1 to n, it'll be R, factorial n, factorial R minus 1, and then n minus R. Now I need to cancel this R also. So I cannot cancel R in this form. So what I'll do is, I'll write it as summation, R varies from 1 to n, and then R minus 1 plus 1, factorial n, R minus 1, and then n minus R. So I'll split the summation in two parts. So I'll write it as summation, R varies from 1 to n, R minus 1, factorial n, factorial R minus 1, n minus R, and then plus summation, R varies from 1 to n, factorial n, so this n gets multiplied with 1, and then R minus 1, and then it'll be factorial n minus R. So here I'll cancel this R minus 1 with R minus 1 into factorial R minus 2. So I'll write it as summation R varies from 1 to n, and here will be factorial n, factorial R minus 2, and then n minus R. Now here one more thing that I can do is, I can change it from, rather than taking it from 1 to n, I can take it from 2 to n, because I know when R is 1, then 1 minus 1 will be 0. So the term containing the value of R equals to 1 will be 0. So I'll change the summation from 2 to n. And for the second one, I'm going to write it as summation R varies from 1 to n and will be factorial n R minus 1 and then n minus R. Now here I have R minus 2. So in the numerator, I'll need n minus 2. So I'll write it as n minus 1 into factorial n minus 2, and here it is R minus 1, so I'll write it as n into factorial n minus 1. So I'll take this common, so I'll write n minus 1 summation R varies from 2 to n, and this will be n minus 2 C R minus 2, and plus here I can take n common, so I'll write summation R varies from 1 to n, and here will be n minus 1 C R minus 1. So now it is n minus 1, and it is nothing but n minus 2 C0, n minus 2 C1, and then n minus 2 C, n minus 2. And for the second one, I'll get n, it'll be n minus 1 C0, n minus 1 C1, and n minus 1 C, n minus 1. So this is n minus 1. Now sum of the series, it's a standard series, which is 2 to the power n minus 2. And the sum of this series is 2 to the power n minus 1. So that is the answer to this question. So I can take n common and 2 to the power n minus 2 common. So if I take n into 2 to the power n minus 2 common, then I'll get n minus 1 and then plus 2. So it is n plus 1 into 2 to the power n minus 2. So we can solve these questions using algebraic method. Now the question is, we need to find the sum of the series, which is nc0 upon 1, nc1 upon 2, nc2 upon 3, and ncn upon n plus 1. So again, I'll express it as summation. So I'll write it as summation. The value of R varies from 0 to n, and then it'll be ncr. So when it is 0, it is 1. For 1, it is 2. So then it'll be R plus 1. So I'm going to write it as summation. R varies from 0 to n, factorial n, factorial R, and then factorial n minus R. Now I can write this R plus 1 into factorial R as factorial R plus 1. So I'll write it as summation R varies from 0 to n, and here it is factorial R plus 1, and this is n minus R, and it is factorial n. So now it is R plus 1 and it is still n minus R. So in the numerator also I'll need n plus 1. So what I'll do is, I'll multiply and divide it with n plus 1. Now I can take this n plus 1 out. So I'll write 1 upon n plus 1, and then summation, value of R varies from 0 to n. So it'll be factorial n plus 1, factorial R plus 1, and then factorial n minus R, which is nothing but n plus 1 C R plus 1. So it is 1 upon n plus 1, And then summation, the value of r varies from 0 to n. It is n plus 1 c r plus 1. So if I'll expand the series, I can write as 1 upon n plus 1. And it'll be, if I'll put r as 0, I'll get n plus 1 c 1, n plus 1 c 2, and then n plus 1 c n plus 1. Now I have this series, but then n plus 1 c 0 term is missing. So what I need to do is, I'll add n plus 1 c 0, and I'll also subtract n plus 1 c 0. So I can write it as 1 upon n plus 1, and this is n c 0 plus n c n, so which will be 2 to the power n. So in this case, it'll be 2 to the power of n plus 1, and then minus n plus 1 c 0, which is 1. So answer to this series will be 2 to the power n plus 1 minus 1 upon n plus 1. So the question is, nc0 upon 1 into 2, nc1 2 into 3, nc2 3 into 4, and ncn n plus 1 into n plus 2. So again, I'll write it in summation form. So I'll write summation, r varies from 0 to n, and then it'll be ncr upon, now here it'll be r plus 1 and r plus 2. So I'll write ncr as summation, r varies from 0 to n, and here it'll be factorial n. Now this is r plus 1 r plus 2 into factorial r, and then factorial n minus r. So I can write factorial r into r plus 1 into r plus 2 as factorial r plus 2. So I'll write it as summation, r varies from 0 to n, and this is factorial r plus 2, and then n minus r. So here we have changed it to r plus 2, and it is still n minus r. So I'll need n plus 2. So what I'll do is, in the numerator also, I'll multiply n plus 1, n plus 2, and I'll multiply and divide with. So in the denominator also, I'll multiply it with n plus 1 and n plus 2. So I'll take it out of the summation. So I'll write 1 upon n plus 1, n plus 2, and then summation. Value of r varies from 0 to n, and here it'll be factorial n plus 2, factorial r plus 2, and then factorial n minus r, which is nothing but 1 upon n plus 1, n plus 2 into summation over all r varies from 0 to n, it'll be n plus 2 c r plus 2. Now I'll expand this series. If I'll expand the series, I can write it as 1 upon n plus 1, n plus 2, and then if I'll put r as 0, I'll get n plus 2 c 2, n plus 2 c 3, and continue up to n plus 2 c n plus 2. Now in this series, there are two terms which are missing, right? So I'll add them. So I'll add n plus 2 c 0, and then n plus 2 c 1, and because I've added them, I need to subtract them also. So I'll write minus n plus 2 c 0 and minus n plus 2 c 1. Now this series, it's a standard binomial coefficient series. So this one will be 1 upon n plus 1, n plus 2, and it'll be 2 to the power n plus 2, and then nc0 is simply 1, and then minus nc1 is n, so it will be n plus 2. So answer to this question will be 2 to the power n plus 2 minus n minus 3 upon n plus 1 into n plus 2. So this method, we call it algebraic method. So let us take another question, which is nc1 upon 2, nc3 upon 4, nc5 upon 6. So I'll express it in terms of summation. So it'll be summation over some r, where r starts from 1. And then here it is 1, 3, 5, which is odd numbers. So it is nc, I'll be 2r minus 1, 2r. So I'll write it as summation, r starts from 1, and then it'll be factorial n, 2r, I'll be 2r minus 1 factorial, and then it'll be n minus 2r, and then plus 1. So I'm going to write it as summation r starting from 1, and then factorial n, it'll be factorial 2r, and here it'll be n plus 1 minus 2r factorial. Now here we have 2r, and here it is n plus 1 minus 2r. So I need n plus 1 in the numerator, so I'll multiply and divide it with n plus 1. So I'll take this n plus 1 out. So I'll write 1 upon n plus 1, and here I'll get summation r starts from 1, and this factorial n plus 1 factorial 2r, and then n plus 1 minus 2r, which is 1 upon n plus 1, and then summation r starts from 1 and it will be n plus 1 c 2r. So if I'll express this summation, if I'll expand it, I'll get 1 upon n plus 1, and here it will be n plus 1 c 2, n plus 1 c 4, n plus 1 c 6. Now the first term is missing, so I'll add n plus 1 c 0, and I'll also subtract n plus 1 c 0. Now what is sum of all the coefficients containing even terms? So that is 1 upon n plus 1, and it is 2 to the power n minus 1. So n plus 1 minus 1, and then minus 1. So in this case, answer will be 2 to the power n minus 1 upon n plus 1.
If you like the video, consider subscribing and sharing it with someone you know who might benefit from it. Also, the best way to navigate any topic is through a playlist. Simply go to the channel page, click playlist, and select the topic you wish to study.